I just found the most insane science gadgets.
Like a blaster that fires real lightning.
Gloves that let me climb walls like Spider-Man.
Or a plasma reactor that lets me shape raw energy.
And up first is this gadget that creates 3D holograms.
This gadget is a 3D mirroscope, and it can turn any object into a hologram. This gadget is made up of two curved mirrors. And when the real object is placed at the bottom and you close it up, the mirrors reflect light onto each other, creating a focal point at the top, which makes the floating image you see. You can put anything in it. You want a cookie? Psych, it's not real. Want to get rich?
Psych, you're broke.
But this next gadget is real. I'm holding a tube of plasma in my hand. It might not look like it, but let's charge up the air around my fingers to 100,000 volts and see what happens. That glow is crazy. So these are tubes of luminous gases, and they light up when they come near the Tesla coil. So how does it work? You can think of the atoms in this tube as a jar of fireflies. Right now, the fireflies are sleeping, but when it gets close to the Tesla coil, it's like a mini thunderstorm. The Tesla coil emits energy that excites the atoms, which knocks off electrons, and these collisions emit light energy. This whole entire process is called ionization. And different gases glow different colors when they turn into plasma. Neon glows orange, argon is a light purple, helium glows white, krypton glows blue, and xenon glows an aqua color. One of our later gadgets will use this luminous gas to create something you've probably never seen before.
I can bend water with this next gadget, the Chinese spouting bowl, turning calm waters into a raging wave. Sadly, I'm not the next avatar. I just know how to use science. So this bowl and the handle is made of bronze, which vibrates easily. So that means if I start rubbing these handles, it will start creating friction, which is then translating into a vibration throughout the entire bowl. These vibrations cause the entire bowl to resonate, creating ripples. And at higher frequencies, the energy is so strong it throws the water upwards, creating the spouting effect. And the harder I rub, the more she squirts. Yeah!
This next gadget is able to make things levitate. If we put in this piece of foam, you can see it starts floating. And it's not using any strings at the top or the bottom. Instead, it's using sound waves to keep it afloat.
If you listen carefully, you might be able to hear a slight buzzing sound.
There are two transducers, one at the top and the bottom, which are basically like high frequency speakers. They produce an ultrasonic sound wave. These sound waves travel in different directions, but share the same frequency and amplitude. This creates a standing wave pattern. In this pattern, there are stable points called nodes, and these nodes create tiny invisible pockets of air pressure strong enough to cancel out gravity.
So when you place a lightweight object in one of these nodes, they should start floating.
It's completely floating, no strings attached. So now we learn to bend water and sound. Next, it's time to harness the power of fire. This gadget turns fire into electricity, so you can charge your phone and doom scroll TikTok even in the wild. It's called the BioLite stove, and all we have to do is stuff our wood into the hole and start our fire. As the stove burns, it generates electricity through the thermoelectric generator inside. And we will know once it's generated electricity if we press this button and a fan turns on.
Ah,
it's creating like a vortex effect. That's kind of cool. So the electricity generator works by having a hot side inside the fire chamber right here, and there's a cool side inside of the fan chamber right here. The temperature difference creates a flow of electrons, which generates electricity. This is called the Seebeck effect. So the hotter the fire burns, the more power is generated. Normally, I wouldn't burn fire inside just because of all the smoke. The other cool effect of these fans is that they pump in more oxygen, making the fire burn hotter and cleaner, creating a smokeless flame. So let's test if this is actually gonna be able to charge my phone. Oh, it's charging, it's charging, let's go. Any excess energy that's not being used to charge will be stored in the internal battery bank. And this thing comes with attachments. Got a grill right here. With the grill, we can make some grilled cheese. Let's flip her around. very burnt grilled cheese. The cheese of truth. And we'll let it cook a little bit because I like my cheese drippy, bruh. Our cheese is now very drippy.
We also have another attachment that we need to brew tea for our next gadget. This next gadget is an assassin's tool used by the ancient Chinese. It's not a knife. This is the assassin's teapot, and it allows you to pour multiple drinks from the same spout. So how it works is, pretend we're at a tea ceremony, which was very popular back in the days. An assassin will pour tea for themselves and drink it to gain their enemy's trust. Then they would pour the poison for their target. And since both liquids came from the same teapot, the enemy would drink the poison tea and no one will expect a thing. Mission accomplished. So how it works is the teapot has two chambers inside and two holes near the handles. One up here and one down here. By covering a specific hole, you control the air pressure and surface tension, allowing one drink to pour while keeping the other sealed. It's kind of like how you can trap water in a straw by covering a hole, but once you let go, the liquid shoots out. So covering the top releases a blue drink, covering the bottom releases a red drink, and leaving both open, you mix the two drinks, which would make purple. But if you're not trying to unalive anyone, this teapot would make a great party trick because you can put tea in one chamber, milk in another, or serve both combined to make milk tea. How is this table floating? It looks like it should collapse, but somehow it's rock solid. This is a tensegrity table, a structure that seems impossible at first glance, but there's no trickery, just pure physics. It's actually only held together by a few strings, but it holds a surprising amount of weight. It's the same engineering concept using Olympic arenas, bridges, and even NASA space structures. But how does something so flimsy hold so much weight? It all comes down to the balance of forces. In the center, the solid metal parts of the table are in compression, meaning they're pushing down. But the string over here is in tension, that means it's pulling up. So these forces perfectly counteract each other, keeping the whole structure floating. And the outside strains are there to provide stability so the whole thing can stand up properly. But we gotta find out how strong it really is. So let's try a phone, all right? No problem. Now let's try a laptop. No way. We gotta test the weight limit. So let's start by putting some dominoes on top of the laptop. So the laptop is about 1.5 kilograms with the case. Each domino is 5 grams. So we'll just keep adding until it topples. While I'm adding weight, let me tell you how you can get your own tensegrity structure for only 1 penny. You heard me right, only 1 cent. Quantities are limited and it's first come, first serve. So listen up. And all this is possible all thanks to Odoo. We added 10 dominoes so far. So Odoo is an all-in-one business tool with apps like accounting, project management, and website build. The first app you use is free for life. You guys probably already know Odoo because we've done 2 huge giveback events before, but this time we're doing it bigger and better. We have 100 DIY tensegrity building kits ready to go, all for 1 cent each. And in the future, the more you show love to Odoo by making your own free website, the more we can give back to you. So the website where you can buy the stuff for a cent, I built using Odoo with zero technical skills. Odoo just asked me for a few prompts, made a ready to go template, and I just dragged and dropped what I needed. Odoo even gives you a free custom domain for 1 year. So if you ever thought about building a website, this is the easiest way to start. And it's free, so there's nothing to lose. Now go to halfago.odoo.com to grab your tensegrity building kit for 1 penny. And check out Odoo's tools while you're there. And if you want to start your own website for free, just click the link in my description or at the bottom of my website. Enjoy your gift. Let's just keep piling it on. You think it's gonna hold? Oh, it's tipping. This table is invincible. Let's just see if we can sit on it. Here we go. I broke it. No fat jokes, please. Now that you've witnessed the impossible, it's time to see the invisible. This next gadget allows you to see a world that's invisible to your naked eye. This is a tiny microscope. And unlike a traditional microscope, you can take this anywhere and look at anything at the microscopic level. And the best part is that it even has a screen on it, so you don't have to like squint and like try to look with one eye. We have a few slides of specimens. So this one is the mouth of a fly. Let's see what that looks like under the microscope. We just need to point it at our object here and use this dial to focus. Damn, that's crazy. You can see the individual hairs. Because it's so portable, we can actually use it to look at anything. Let's look at our phone. Whoa, you can see the individual's red, green, and blue pixels that make up all the colors. All right, I'm gonna get a human specimen right here. Please,
Turn upside down.
Get on there.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Okay.
There we go.
Hey, man.
Get up there. Okay. All right, let's take a look at you. Take a look at your skin. Whoa, all right. You got a lot of micro hairs. All right. Let's take a look at your eyes.
Whoa.
There's a lot of like texture in your eyeball, actually. Let's see what hair looks like. Very healthy looking hair, actually.
Thank you.
Very clean strands of hair. All right, thank you. Thank you.
Same time next week. This microscope is awesome. You can look at anything, even your tiny little piece. This gadget lets you turn into real life Spider-Man. It's called the Grabo, and it's a vacuum powered suction tube. So a regular suction cup works by pressing out air, but the Grabo actively sucks out even more air, making the outside air pressure push down even harder. Usually the Grabo is used to lift furniture or big slabs of concrete. So even if you add more weight, it can still lift. The Grabo claims to lift 370 pounds, which means it should probably lift my weight. Let's put that to the test. Here we go. Gonna lift my feet now. Yo! Yeah! Yo! That's pretty strong. This got me thinking. What can you do with two Grabos? If one Grabo is enough to lift my entire body weight, I can use the other Grabo to move up, suck on, hang on to that one, and then keep moving up so I can climb walls like Spider-Man. Time to reveal my secret identity. I was Peter Parker all along. It's a lot harder than I thought. So I think we need something to support my legs. Okay, we made some major upgrades. We have industrial grade ratchet straps so I can rest my foot. I've also changed to barefoot shoes, which allows me to flex and climb the walls more easily. Hopefully these upgrades together will allow me to scale the wall. Here we go. My goal is to touch the yellow part. Great. Oh, shoot. All right, here we go. We gotta lift one foot. All right, okay. That one's pretty good. Moving up. Oh, yo. This is pretty sick. Going pretty high. Now we gotta go up with this. All right, here we go. Punch. Mission accomplished. Now we gotta come down. Spider-Man. Now that's the power of science, baby. Each time I moved up, I was super scared that one of these would give out. And once I got up there, it looked pretty high. But thankfully, science kept me alive. This is a lightning gun. Oh, you see that? It's actually called a Tesla coil blaster. And the Tesla coil works by converting the electricity from these lithium ion batteries into high voltage, high frequency electricity. So your toaster runs at 120 volts. But a Tesla coil can run up to 100,000 volts. And the big Tesla coil can run up to 1 million volts. And since this is handheld, you can shoot this at anyone, anywhere. Should we try? Ooh. It stings a little bit, but it doesn't really hurt. And after I get zapped, I can feel a surge of electricity. So if the Tesla coil produces such high voltage, why is it still safe to touch? It's because voltage is only the electric potential. But just like you, you probably won't reach your potential. So imagine electricity is water flowing through a hose. Voltage is the water pressure, and amps is the amount of water flowing through. So even if the hose has really high pressure, if there's very little water flowing through, it's not gonna hurt me. And a Tesla coil is safe to touch because it has really low amps. But that brief spark is still enough to burn things. For our first experiment, we can see the pattern of lightning if we use our Tesla coil on the receipt, because receipts are heat sensitive. Oh my gosh, it's immediate. You can immediately see the lightning pattern forming. It was completely white before. Now look at all the burn marks. Let's see if it can pop this balloon. Woo! Impressive. But can it light a match? Oh. Damn. Let's find out if a Tesla coil gun can roast a marshmallow. The Tesla coil gun is cool, but our next gadget uses electricity in an even more interesting way. This gadget is one of the coolest things I've ever seen. It took me a long time to find where to get it, but it was worth the wait. Just take a look. Look at that! Does that not look magical to you? So this is called a toroid plasma reactor. And toroid is just the name of the donut shape, which is what you see. And with this, we can control the power, which then controls the shape of our plasma.
if you get close to it, you can actually hear the sound of plasma vibrating against the glass.
But if I pick up the globe, the light eventually dies. So what's going on here? How does this work? There's two parts to this. The machine down here is generating an electric field, kind of like an induction stove. That's why when I bring the globe close to it, it will start to light up because the electricity is ionizing the xenon gas inside and turning it into plasma. The exact same process with the luminous gas experiment earlier. But what makes this gadget 10 times cooler is how the toroid, the donut shape, is created. And that's through these coils right here. These circular coils are creating a magnetic field, which is influencing the shape of the plasma inside. That's why as I turn the power up or down, the shape changes. And if you get it just right, it creates a perfect toroid. These gadgets prove that learning about science is not lame. Instead, it's the closest thing we have to real magic in real life. So click here to watch another Science Gadgets video, and click here to watch a video that YouTube thinks you'll love. Subscribe.